The Kenya Initiative for Development and Sustainability is a charitable organization that I founded a number of years back, which focuses on finding sustainable solutions for our partners in Kenya. So what we look at doing is adopting programs that are already in place. These can be programs like schools that have already been constructed and in effect, children's centers that might have been supporting children but are in need of assistance, HIV/AIDS centers that have already been working towards awareness, prevention, and care for individuals in the community, and IDP camps who are in need of assistance in terms of meeting basic needs and then developing sustainable solutions to generate income for the community and for families, and to be able to provide other rights such as education for children. So because there's so many other programs that are already in place, what we wanted to do is we wanted to focus on those ones. We wanted to support the community members that are in charge of these programs, and we wanted to ensure that we can get them to a sustainable point sooner rather than later. And this way, Kids Initiative can look at retiring the sustainable programs and adopting new ones in need of assistance. So how do we do this? We look at doing this through local fundraising and educational programming here in Manitoba. And honestly, if it weren't for our donors, our volunteers, and our supporters here at home, we wouldn't be able to continue doing the work that we have been doing. And we've already seen such great successes in our programs. We've even been able to retire an IDP camp due to achieving sustainable status. So what our goal is that we want to continue to support 5 core programs at a time. We want to make sure that we're making the biggest impact we possibly can, because we can.
The thing about kids is, with so little, you can do so much, and that really makes the whole organization that important. My name is Jeff Archambault, and I'm board chair of Kids Initiative. To learn that $100 US can feed 517 kids for a month, and to learn that that's one dinner out, and to, you know, sometimes maybe it's like maybe we can do without that one dinner at that month and help these kids, and to know they can change the lives of 517 kids and that they can actually get an education because they're not hungry anymore. When I first heard about the IDP camps and refugee camps, I always thought that they're temporary provisions for families. But coming here, I realized that these are permanent new homes for these people, and that they've been displaced because of war or the government has kicked them off certain land. So to have them come here with nothing and have to start all over, it just blows my mind how they can do this and pick up and be moved into this new area that they're not familiar with. I think the biggest thing that I've learned is how appreciative everyone is. We're back home, we're raising funds, we're trying to get people to come to our events and to donate to us. And it's just, it's so far away from Canada that people are like, well, why are we giving to people thousands of miles away? And but they need our help. And it's amazing how little it takes to help.